Hello, Milepost One. I have to tell you, before we start IPC today, I am super, super excited because it's three of my favorite things all in one IPC lesson. Firstly, it's art, and I'm a huge fan. I love art. I love sitting down with my pencils, with my sketchbook, and drawing absolutely anything. The second reason I'm excited is it's photos. Now, I love taking photos. Like photography, I like to go out with my camera. I especially like looking for animals to take pictures of, but that's something I really, really enjoy doing. And then the third reason I'm excited is because later on in this presentation, there are some very cool buildings, and I cannot wait to share some of these weird and wonderful places with you. But let's start by talking about photos. This is a drawing or an engraving of the first camera, or what people think the first camera could have looked like. Obviously, there aren't any photos of the first camera because cameras had only just been invented. You can't take a picture of a camera with the first camera. It was invented in around 1826. That's about 200 years ago. Some people think 1826, some people think 1827. But still, 200 years ago, the first camera was invented by a man called Joseph Nicephore Niépce. And this is supposed to be him in this picture. Now I'm going to show you the next slide. Have a look at that. Wow, isn't that amazing? Don't you just love this? Do you know what it is? This is the world's first photograph. I know, incredible. Do you know what it's a picture of? No, neither do I. Because back then, the technology wasn't very good. So 200 years ago, this is what photographs looked like. They have improved. They've improved a lot, and they keep getting better and better as we get more and more interesting and amazing technology. I'm going to show you some other first photographs. See if you can work out what they are. Have a look at this one. What do you think? I mean, obviously, you can see buildings and you can see trees in this photograph. Now, this photograph is actually the first photograph ever with a person in it. Here he is. Tiny person down here. It's a man getting his shoes cleaned. Now, this photograph took 7 minutes to take. The person had to press the button to start the camera and then hold it still for 7 minutes. Now it's just one click, ching, photo taken straight away. But back in these days, 200 years ago, this person would have to have their camera on a stand and leave it for 7 minutes. So there were other people walking around. But because the photo took so long, the exposure was so long, the camera couldn't catch those people. But this man was standing still, having his shoes cleaned, and that's why he's the person in the photo. Now, if you look really carefully, you can see other people in the picture, but they are a bit more blurry than this tiny, tiny man having his shoes cleaned. So this is the first photo of a person. Let's have a look at the next one. Now you can see that the technology is already better. This is about 10 years after the picture we've just seen. So 10 years later, cameras and photos are better already. This is a man called Robert Cornelius. And this is the first selfie. Now, for us, selfies are really easy. We just take the phone camera, swap it around so it's looking at us, click, and it's done, and we can put it on Class Dojo, we can put it on Facebook, on Instagram, all over, anywhere you want to put it. You can send it to family across the world. This is the first selfie. To get this picture to look this good, Robert Cornelius had to sit still for 1 minute. Now, the camera was on a stand, so the camera wasn't going to move, but he had to sit still for 1 minute. If he'd moved around, his face would have been all blurry. even more blurry than it is at the moment. Now, cameras have changed a lot over the years. This is a very, very old style camera, and you can see them getting a bit more modern. This one here, if you're in year two, this is a bit like the camera, the underwater camera that was found in the story Flotsam. Big flush on this one. And then we start to see, yeah, this is starting to look like cameras we see now. Here is the digital camera and then proper DSLR, which is what Mr. Scullion uses. And then if you're very fancy and you've got a really modern camera, you've got a GoPro, which you can attach to all sorts and do all sorts of funky things with. So cameras have changed a lot. But what did people do before cameras? What if people wanted to remember something before cameras were invented? They couldn't take a picture of it. They couldn't take that photograph because cameras hadn't been invented. Or maybe you didn't have a camera because they were a new invention and they were expensive. So instead, people had a lot more paintings or drawings. Now, in this IPC today, we're going to be looking at buildings from the past. We're going to look at photographs of them, and then we're going to look at some paintings of them. I've been around the world and collected photos and paintings from lots of people's home countries. I might not have included everybody's home country. If I haven't, I'm sorry. I did my very best. But have a look at some of these buildings and see if you know where they are, what they are called, and when they were built. We are traveling in time from the oldest to the newest. Have a look at this one. Does anybody recognize this building? Do you know where it is? Is it in your home country? Let's have a look. It's Italy. And this is called the Colosseum in Rome. Now, this was built nearly 2,000 years ago, in the year 70. We're now in the year 2020. This was built in the year 70, so nearly 2,000 years old. It's absolutely amazing. Now, obviously, 2,000 years ago, cameras didn't exist. Cameras wouldn't exist for about 1,800 years. But there are lots and lots of paintings and pictures of the Colosseum. Here is a really famous one. You can see the building here. Let's go back and have a look at the Colosseum. There it is. You can see the building here. Now, this picture, this painting, is about 300 years old by a very famous painter called Giovanni Paolo Panini. And you can see the Colosseum very clearly in this picture. This painting is 300 years old, so a long time before cameras. And actually, Panini painted lots of pictures of the Colosseum and other parts of Rome. And you can also see statues wearing no clothes. They were very, very popular with Roman sculptures. Okay, we're going to move on to a different part of the world. To this place. Does anybody recognize this building? It looks like a fairy tale castle. Absolutely amazing. Do you know where it is? Is it in your home country? Let's find out. This is in Germany, and it is called Schwerin Castle or Schweriner Schloss. Does anybody want to guess how old it is? Well, there's been a castle here in this place where this castle is since the year 973. So about 1,000 years old. But this version in front of you, this with all of the turrets and the windows and things like that, this version is about 500 years old. Now, 500 years ago, you wouldn't have been able to take a photograph of this, not a beautiful color photograph like this, really clear picture. No, no, no. So people would have to draw it. Well, here is a drawing of that castle that is about 400 years old. And you can see some of the things have changed, some of the things are the same. This is a drawing that somebody did 400 years ago. Before cameras were invented, people had to draw instead. The next one, we've had a look at Italy, we've had a look at Germany. Where are we going next? Does anybody recognize this building? Has anybody been to any of these places? I'd be really interested if you have. I'd love to hear more about it. Now, this is in France. It's actually in Paris, the capital city of France. And it is called Notre Dame Cathedral, or Cathédrale Notre Dame. Very, very famous cathedral that was built in 1345. This is about 700 years old. Unfortunately, last year there was a big fire and lots of the cathedral was destroyed. So people are having to rebuild it. This one here, it was finished in 1345, but it took nearly 200 years to build it. That's a very, very long time to be doing any job, 200 years. Can you imagine if me or Miss Rowe, if we asked you to do a maths activity that lasted for 200 years, don't think you'd be too pleased about that. But look at the beautiful creation, amazing windows and the enormous towers. A very, very beautiful old building, 700 years old. Now, 700 years ago, there weren't any cameras, so people would have to draw or paint if they wanted to remember it. Here is another painting. Now, this painting is just over 100 years ago. Cameras were around then, so this person chose to do a painting instead of a picture. He might not have had the money to buy a camera, so he had to paint it instead. But you can see big towers we saw in this picture. And you can see the shape of the window there we saw in this picture. This is by an American artist called Hassan. Okay, so this one was about 700 years old. We're moving on to this one. Does anybody recognize this building? You should by now. We've looked at this before in our IPC this term. Is this in your home country? Well, it's in the country we're all in right now. This is in Kenya. And it is Fort Jesus. Now, Fort Jesus was built about 400 years ago, more than 400 years ago. And it was built by some Portuguese people with the help of a lot of slaves. So people who the Portuguese told they had to build it. And they didn't live in very nice conditions. The Portuguese sailors are all around the world. 400 years ago, Portuguese people were exploring all around the world, from here all the way over to Japan. Really, really wide range of exploration. Now, there are lots and lots of black and white photographs of Fort Jesus, if you have a look on the internet. In fact, in some restaurants in Diani, you can go and see black and white photographs of Fort Jesus when we're all allowed back into the restaurants all of the time. But here is a painting by a South African artist called Pieter Hugo. And you can see the walls of Fort Jesus. This painting is about 100 years old. The interesting thing about Fort Jesus is there are actually paintings on the walls of Fort Jesus that Portuguese people did 400 years ago. So this is a painting of Fort Jesus, but if you go to Fort Jesus, you can see paintings on the wall. So Pieter Hugo will not have owned a camera. He was a poor artist, so he will have painted Fort Jesus on his own explorations. Okay, from Kenya, we're traveling east. Does anybody recognize this? This obviously is a photograph. We've got the lovely reflection in the water in front of this very famous building in India. Does anybody know what it is called? This is the Taj Mahal, and it's visited by millions of people every year. They fill these paths around and they go and look at this amazing building that was built in 1653, so again about 400 years ago. And this building is incredibly famous around the world. People have taken hundreds, thousands, millions of photographs of it, but before cameras were invented, people had to draw or paint. Here is a painting by a man called William Hodges, who's from England. Now, he joined a famous explorer called Cook on Cook's exploration of the world. So 250 years ago, or 230 years ago, Hodges went exploring with Cook, and Hodges was a painter, so he did lots of paintings, and you can see the Taj Mahal clearly hasn't changed very much in the last 230 years. Right, so from India, we are traveling to this place, another very famous building. You know where it is? Right, well, this is in the USA. This is in the United States of America. And it is the White House. Now, this is where the president lives. And the White House was built in 1792. And it has changed a lot over the years. They've added bits and they've changed bits. But if we look back 200 years at a painting, we can see that it looks quite similar. Look at these columns here. One, two, three, four columns. Those are these four columns here. One, two, three, four. Hasn't changed much in the last 200 years. The trees have grown a bit, haven't they? Look at the size of this tree. Look at the size of these tiny little saplings. Now, this is a painting by an American called George Munger. Look, what do you notice about these windows? Look inside. Can you see any glass? Why do you think there's no glass? And what are all these black bits around all of the windows? There was a famous fire at the White House. That's why this painting was made by George Munger. This is a painting of the White House just after the fire. Now, 1814, still no cameras. Another 12 years before the first camera was invented. So that's why it had to be drawn or painted. I think this is amazing how he must have used a ruler or a straight line, something to draw straight lines to create this building. And then after he'd drawn it in pencil, he's painted it. Okay, from America, we move on to this place. Does anybody recognize this? I wouldn't be surprised if you don't. This is my home country. This is in Wales. This is in Cardiff. This is a place called Cardiff Bay. We're actually looking at this building here. This is the Custom House. This red brick building. And we've got loads of modern buildings behind, look, with these slanting roofs. This one made of glass over here, that's the Welsh Assembly where the government meet. This shiny one at the back looks like it's made of copper. That's the Millennium Center where you can go and watch plays. Got a speedboat here. These are all modern things. But this building here is very old. It's the Custom House. It was built in 1839. So cameras have been invented. So you can see black and white photos of the Custom House. But I've got a painting from 110 years ago for us to look at, of the Custom House. Now, you might be looking at that thinking, Mr. Scullion, that's not a Custom House, that's a big ship. You are right, but if you look in the background, here is the Custom House. No fancy modern buildings around it anymore, because 110 years ago they didn't exist. But the Custom House is still there. This is a very famous ship. This is called the Terra Nova. The Terra Nova with Captain Scott, who tried to get to the South Pole. It didn't go very well for Captain Scott. That's a very famous story that you will learn when you are in year 5 or year 6. Now, this is the Custom House in the background, but all of the fancy buildings have gone. 110 years ago, you will have, there are photographs of this moment. Some people like to paint it because they can add their own bits. You know, maybe it wasn't a lovely blue sky with some fluffy white clouds when this ship set sail. But the painter can decide, actually, I'm going to put blue sky and fluffy clouds because it's my painting and that's what I want it to look like. That's the great thing about paintings, is that, sure, you can paint what is exactly in front of you, or you can change some bits because you feel like it. You can't really do that with photographs. So we come on to your job for the day. Now, you've got cameras, so you can do fancy photos, but we're going to swap things around slightly. For your job today, I'm going to show you not an old building, I'm going to show you a new building, and it's your job to draw or paint or make the new building. Now you can decide what you do, depending on what you've got at your house. If you've only got pencils, draw it and cover it in. If you've got some paints, you could use paints. If you've got collage materials, you know, bits of paper or bits of tin foil or bits of anything that you can cut out and stick on to make that building, that will be really interesting to see as well. It's up to you. Get creative. You are the artist. Nobody is telling you what to do. Here is one of the buildings you could choose from. There is a choice. This is in Bilbao, in Spain. And this building is an art museum called the Guggenheim. Look at the shapes, amazing shapes of this building. Really, really shiny. Lots of different shades. We've got the darker shades up here, light shades here. We've got the water in front with some reflection in it. And we've got this mist. There are fountains around this Guggenheim that don't squirt out water. They squirt out this mist. And then we've got a spider. Because why not? It's an art gallery. Over here, we've got another sculpture with lots of shiny balls all stuck together. The Guggenheim in Bilbao. You could draw this one. Another famous building you could choose is this one. Does anybody recognize this? This is the Sydney Opera House in Australia. Amazing shapes. Now, this is not a brand new building. It's been around for about 40 years. Look at the amazing shapes and look carefully, if you decide to draw this one, at these bits that are really, really light and these bits that are really, really dark. Think about your paint colors, think about your pencil colors, or think about your shading. Really, really light, really, really dark. Got this big black line that goes across here. And then the lovely soft reflections in the water. Okay, Sydney Opera House is another choice. Here is a different choice. Now this is a very cool photograph. The exposure is nice and low, so we've got these streaky meow, 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 car lights driving past. The car was so fast, the cameras haven't been able to pick up the light. Now this is another art gallery, also called the Guggenheim, but this one is in New York, in the United States. It's in New York City, Guggenheim. So this is a Guggenheim in Spain, and this is a Guggenheim in New York. You could draw this one. Look at the funky shape of this building. What does it look like to you? Does it look like a big pasta bowl stuck on top of another building? Or, no, like a stack of plates, maybe. A really, really interesting and modern building with other modern buildings around it as well. And then another one that you could choose, these ones. Really cool building. Or buildings joined together by the floating bridge. These are the Petronas Towers in Kuala Lumpur. Huge, tall buildings. I love the dark sky in this photograph, but you know, you could decide, because it's your drawing, to do fluffy white clouds. Lovely straight lines leading to it for these water features with the trees following them as well. That's super tough to draw. If you look carefully, you might need to use a ruler to get these straight lines, but you could draw an awesome picture of the Petronas Towers. Now I have put four here for you to choose from, but you don't have to. You can go on the internet with a grown-up and find another interesting building. Maybe an interesting building that you've been to if you don't want to draw one of these. Some of these have got wobbly lines, wiggly lines, curved lines. Some of these have got very, very straight lines. It's entirely up to you. If you've drawn one and you had an amazing time, draw another one. It'd be great to see your art. And use anything that you want at home. Use paint, use pencils, use coloring pencil, use chalk, use crayon, use bits of paper, use bits of material. It's up to you. You are the artist. You get to decide. If you were taking a photo, it'd be point and click. But right now, you can use anything you want to create these amazing buildings. I'm super excited because I love these buildings. I haven't been to this one. I haven't been to this one. I haven't been to this one. I have been to this one. If you've been to one of the others, let me know and tell me what it was like. Right, I look forward to seeing your art. I can't wait to see your creativity. I'm super excited. And we're starting now to think about buildings of the past, and we'll do more of that on Monday. Send me your pictures and I'll share them on our own Class Dojo pages so you can see what everybody else is doing as well. OK? because I think that would be really nice for us to all see each other's pictures. See you soon, everybody. Bye.